This is an auto-narrated audiobook generated by Google. Book: The Young Man in Business. Author: Edward Book. Year: 1900. Topic: The Young Man in Business. A well-known New York millionaire gave it as his opinion not long ago that any young man possessing a good constitution and a fair degree of intelligence might acquire riches. The statement was criticized, literally picked to pieces, and finally adjudged as being extravagant. The figures then came out, gathered by a careful statistician, that of the young men in business in New York City, 60% were earning less than $1,000 per year, only 20% had an income of $2,000, and barely 5% commanded salaries in excess of the latter figure. The great majority of young men in New York City, that is, between the ages of 23 and 30, were earning less than $20 per week. On the basis, therefore, that a young man must be established in his life profession by his 30th year, it can hardly be said that the average New York young man in business is successful. Of course, this is measured entirely from the standpoint of income. It is true that a young man may not, in every case, receive the salary his services merit, but as a general rule, his income is a pretty accurate indication of his capacity. Now, as every young man naturally desires to make a business success, it is plain from the above statement that something is lacking, either the opportunities or the capabilities in the young men themselves. No one conversant with the business life of any of our large cities can, it seems to me, even for a single moment, doubt the existence of good chances for young men. Take any large city as a fair example: New York, Boston, Philadelphia, or Chicago, and in each instance there exist more opportunities than there are young men capable of embracing them. The demand is far in excess of the supply. Positions of trust are constantly going begging for the right kind of young men to fill them. But such men are not common, or if they be, they have a most unfortunate way of hiding their light under a bushel, so much so that businessmen cannot see even a glimmer of its rays. Let a position of any real importance be open, and it is the most difficult kind of a problem to find anyone to fill it satisfactorily. Businessmen are constantly passing through this experience. Young men are desired in the great majority of positions because of their progressive ideas and capacity to endure work. In fact, young blood, as it is called, is preferred in 9 positions out of every 10 nowadays. The chances for business success for any young man are not wanting. The opportunities exist, plenty of them. The trouble is that the average young man of today is incapable of filling them, or, if he be not exactly incapable, I gladly give him the benefit of the doubt, he is unwilling to fill them, which is even worse. That exceptions can be brought up to controvert, I know, but I am dealing with the many, not with the few. The average young man in business today is nothing more nor less than a plodder, a mere automaton. He is at his office at 8 or 9 o'clock in the morning, is faithful in the duties he performs, goes to luncheon at 12, gets back at 1, takes up whatever he is told to do until 5, and then goes home. His work for the day is done. One day is the same to him as another. He has a certain routine of duties to do, and he does them day in and day out, month in and month out. His duties are regulated by the clock. As that points, so he points. Verily, it is true of him that he is the same yesterday, today, and forever. No special fault can be found with his work. Given a particular piece of work to do, he does it just as a machine would. Such a young man, too.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.